Hey friends, and welcome to my channel. So today I'll discuss the theory of equivalence in translation studies. So actually friends, equivalence can be said to be the central issue in translation. You know, its definition, its relevance, its applicability within the field of translation theory have caused heated controversy. Okay, so in this session I'll try my best to give a most accurate discussion on equivalence. So, while studying equivalence, we have to know Roman Jakobson's view of equivalence, as well as in this session, I will discuss Nida Tiber, this type of theorist's views of equivalence, okay? One important thing, friends, in my channel, you'll also find other videos on translation studies. I'll put the link in the description box, so just check out, okay? So, let's start. So friends, as equivalence theory is related to translation, that's why you have to at least know that what is this translation. So translation means transfer of a text or word written or spoken from one language to another. It means that transfer of a written word or text or spoken words from one language to another by maintaining the meaning of the source language or the attitude of the source language to the target language is called translation. So actually friends, while doing translation, it is actually hard to find absolutely identical words and notions and cultures in different languages, okay? And while doing translation, we need one source language and one target language. So different languages have different phonetic, different grammar system, different syntax and vocabulary structures. So in that case, there is used the equivalence theory to show the likeness between the source and the target text, okay? Because equivalence generally means balance or equity. One critic or renowned theorist named Catford about equivalence theory states that a central task of translation theory is that of defining the nature and conditions of translation equivalence. So thus it is clear that defining equivalence in translation is quite a difficult task. And Roman Jakobson in 1959 first used this term equivalence, okay? So various theorists like Roman Jakobson, Baker, Eugene Nida, Catford is of the view that or is of the opinion that equivalence is a literal translation of each word and notion. But this opinion differs from person to person. According to Kenny, equivalence is used for the sake of convenience, okay? So there are different opinions about the righteousness of equivalence theory. Actually, in the translation process, the factors which actually or mostly affect the human translation is the cultural or linguistic aspects of the source language text as well as the target language text, okay? So, if these cultural or linguistic parameters are as effective and as accurate as expected, then these parameters will help streamline the translation process in a convincing and correct manner. So, in order to truly achieve translation equivalence, there have to be a striking balance between source text and target text. So before discussing about Roman Jakobson and his ideas on equivalence, let us now talk about Jean-Paul Vinet and Jean Darbelnet's view or opinion on equivalence. So in their book, they distinguish between direct and oblique translation. They referred direct translation as literal translation and oblique translation as free translation. And in respect to this, they propose 7 procedures and they are borrowing, calc, literal translation, transposition, modulation, equivalence and adaptation. So here equivalence is viewed as a procedure in which the same situation is replicated as in the original, but here different wording is used. So these are the views of Paul Vinet and Jean Darbelnet. So now let's talk about Roman Jakobson. So Jakobson believed that equivalence comes in 3 types. One is intralingual, it means that equivalence within one language, it means paraphrasing or rewriting the same content, okay? Then interlingual, it means equivalence between languages or 2 languages. And lastly, we have intersemiotic, it means equivalence between sign systems. So among these 3 types of equivalence by Jakobson, the second type means the intralingual, this is the one where translation equivalence is classified in. So after this, we have another theory on equivalence, that is by Eugene Nida and Tiber. So according to them, there are two types of equivalence. One is formal and the other one is dynamic. So formal equivalence can be understood as a word-for-word translation. Okay, so it means that translating the meaning of words and phrases in a more literal way to one language to another. And on the other hand, dynamic equivalence means a sense-for-sense translation. It means that translating the meanings of phrases or whole sentences into one language to another language with readability in mind. So in a more accurate sense, formal equivalence, this approach actually tends to emphasize fidelity to the lexical details and grammatical structure of the original language, okay? Where dynamic equivalence tends to employ a more natural rendering but with less literal accuracy. It means that in formal equivalence, there you'll find the most accurate literal fidelity, and in the dynamic equivalence, you will find less literal accuracy. So Eugene Nida argues that in formal equivalence, the target text resembles very much to the source text in both form and context. Whereas in dynamic equivalence, there an effort is made to convey the source text message in the target text as naturally as possible. Eugene Nida also subscribed to the dynamic equivalence, but later in later years he distanced himself from the term dynamic equivalence and then he preferred the term functional equivalence as best. So apart from them, we have Anton Popovic's view on equivalence. So he describes four kind of equivalence. One is linguistic, other one is paradigmatic, other one is stylistic, and the last one is textual equivalence. So friends, these are the views on equivalence theory by various theorists. I hope that this video will help you, and if yes, then please give it a like and share this video, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. So bye for now, see you in the next session very soon.